Welcome, family and friends. We are here to celebrate life. Yours, mine, ours, Roy's. Life now and eternally.
What cut?
Did I hear you yell cut?
Yes, I did.
Cut?
No ties.
What? No ties? No ties? You just cut my tie.
Yes. Now take it off.
Okay, I'll be casual.
Thank you.
All right. Thank you.
Yeah. Joe, hold him. Rally.
Mike Roy's memorial, take two.
Again, let me welcome you. And we are being filmed. There is a cameraman up in the balcony recording this celebration. Someone told me, it was Bob, that in 1964, he was singing and doing something and looked up in the balcony and saw Roy Williams working for Chiral Television, operating one of the cameras, broadcasting a UPC worship service right up there. And here we are celebrating his life. Peggy, thank you for helping choreograph, and Mike and Peter and family, and all of you as friends. During the stories time of the celebration, there'll be an opportunity for you to raise a hand and share a story, a few words, and maybe someone like Chuck or John or Scott could stand and right where you are, I'll give you a microphone, and you could share a little vignette. Not too long, but enough to get the story out. So thank you for coming. When Jesus began the Sermon on the Mount, he gave us 9 blessings. We call them the Beatitudes. The first two go like this. Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. And blessed are those who mourn, for they shall be comforted. Well, in the course of our celebration, we may have a tear come to our eye. If we mourn, we're welcome. If a smile comes across our face, we're welcome to smile, to laugh, because we celebrate all of life. And that's how we are. That's how we feel. That's what we do when we say, thank you, God, for one Roy Williams. When I think of him, 3 words come to my mind. First one is faith, faith in God. The second one is family, family. And the third one is film. He loved to film and choreograph people and record them and make great things happen. So I'd like you to welcome each other with 2 or 3 words that come to your mind when you think of Roy Williams, and say who you are. Hi, my name's Ray. I think of family, faith, and film. And just talk for 60 seconds. Stand and greet and share 2 or 3 words with each other. Do that right now. Thank you very much. You may be seated. We have a little cluster here that's really going deep with a lot of words. I asked for two or three words, not five paragraphs, but it's fun, right? I heard one word over there, it was cantankerous, but we won't go there. Thank you for coming. The Lord is here. He said, where two or more are gathered in His name, He is present among them. Let's talk to our Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank You that You give us life, eternal life. You give us Your word in Scripture that promises that where two or more are gathered, You are present, and that You gave Your only begotten Son so that whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. So, Lord, we claim Your beatitudes, Your blessings. We claim the one that is for Roy, the kingdom of heaven, and the one for those who mourn, that we will be comforted because we laugh, we share, we sing, we worship, we pray, and we remember. So, Lord, teach us and touch us in a very special way, and we'll give You the praise and the thanks. And all God's people said, amen. Let's take our order of worship and read with one voice Psalm 23, famous for three reasons. It's short, it's personal, I, me, thy, personal pronouns, and Jesus fulfilled it. He said, I am the good shepherd. Let's read it in unison, shall we? The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restores my soul. He leads me in paths of righteousness for His name's sake. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for Thou art with me. Thy rod and Thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup overflows. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. And Paul writes to his friends in Corinth words about comfort and suffering. These words inspired Roy and Mike to dream and envision Comfort Chapel. And you could read about that in the brief file at the back of the bulletin. The Apostle Paul wrote in 2 Corinthians chapter 1, verses 3 through 7, praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of compassion and the God of all comfort, who comforts us in all our troubles, so that we can comfort those in any trouble with the comfort we ourselves receive from God. For just as we share abundantly in the sufferings of Christ, so also our comfort abounds through Christ. If we are distressed, it is for your comfort and salvation. If we are comforted, it is for your comfort, which produces in you patient endurance of the same sufferings we suffer. And our hope for you is firm, because we know that just as you share in our sufferings, so also you share in our comfort. May the Lord bless our readings and this reading to our mind, our heart, our imagination, and application in our lives. May God be praised. Let's watch.
Travel over the vast unknown, and if I stumble along the trail, He'll lasso true and lead me home. I was just an old cowpoke one dark dark and windy day. I became a new creation when the Lord showed me the way. Now I can yodel with my friend Jesus. I'll yippee-yay and yodel-o-tee. I'll sing his praises across the prairie. He's got a range in the sky for me. I eat a low T-O low T-O. I eat a low T-O low T. I eat a low T-O low T-O. I eat a low T-O low T.
There is far, far wonder working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is far, far wonder working power in the precious blood of the Lamb. Would you do service for Jesus your King? There's power in the blood, power in the blood. Would you live daily his praises to sing? There's wonderful power in the blood. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. There is power, power, wonder-working power in the precious blood of the Lamb.
I have found the joy no tongue can tell, how its waves of it is like an overflowing well, springing up within my soul. It is joy unspeakable and full of glory, full of glory, full of glory. It is joy unspeakable and full of glory. Oh, the half has never yet been told.
Savior as my all in all, standing on the promises of God. Standing, standing, standing on the promises of Christ my Savior. Standing, standing, I'm standing on the promises of God.
Dawn till setting sun. Let us talk of all his wondrous love and care. Then when all of life is over and our work on earth is done, and the roll is called up yonder, I'll be there.
When the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder, when the roll is called up yonder,
yeah.
Brenda. Brenda's going to help us sing, and Clint and Bob will accompany us.
We're going to sing Turn Your Eyes Upon Jesus, and the words are going to be on those things. So we're good. Join me, sing good and loud.
Thank you, Brenda and Clint and Bob. A few stories. I think Scott is going to share some, and maybe John Vasco, maybe, who knows, will be kind of spontaneous and raise your hand. If you talk longer than 2 hours, we'll all go home and you'll be here all by yourself. But just a story or two. Scott, where's Scott? Let's see. John Vasco, where are you? Where's John? And Carrie.
Hello, everybody. I worked with Roy for a couple years at Cinema Associates. I had no background in film. I was actually a physician. But Roy saw something that he thought would be useful for him. So I worked there. And we did some really interesting and fun things. Roy was a great person to work for. And he had wonderful ideas, and it was really a joy to work with Roy and to get to know Peggy and the kids. I'll never forget one time we took a trip down to Arizona and do some filming with Jeff Cooper, who was a very famous gun guy and very well known in the gun community. And we went down and filmed him at his ranch in Arizona on how to shoot pistols. That was just fantastic. And I understand that stuff is still around. I'm gonna try to find it and look at it. But Roy called me a producer. That was a joke. Yeah, using the word very lightly. But we also did a series on the Christian life with Charlie Shedd and his wife, and we did that. We filmed it over, a lot of it over on the peninsula and Puget Sound on sailboats and all kinds of. Roy had some fantastic ideas, and I got to be a little bit of a part of that, and I got to edit those films, and that was really fun. So I look back on those times with Roy with great fondness, and I miss him. You want to say anything?
How about that backyard?
Oh, yeah. Well, that was the real special one they did together in our backyard out in Shoreline. And it was with Elizabeth Elliot. You may have read recently that she passed on, the wonderful writer and wife of, I'm trying to think of his name, but the gentleman that went to Auca Indians, and they were all slain, the five of them. But then he also did a bit with Dale Evans Rogers, and that was fun. I got to meet her. What a gal. So, you know, he seemed to have boundless ideas and knew how to fulfill them.
We're going to see some clips of those movies a little bit later. Chuck, where's Chuck? Over there. Now, you can't talk longer than 2 hours, Chuck.
Well, Roy and I grew up together, and there's four of us that all had our birthdays in April, and three of them are gone already. And so I, Lord, let me stay a little bit longer. But there's a lot of things we did together, but two things stand out in my mind. Number one, related to films. That first picture you made for Weyerhaeuser, he was telling me they were filming Weyerhaeuser reseeding the area that they'd forested. And he said the seeds didn't show up very well on the film. So Roy ran out to the local grocery store, bought box after box of Rice Krispies. So he poured them into the hoppers, and so he said, as you saw that plane reseeding, as the narrator was saying, it was Rice Krispies. And then another important thing that I remember was in his home. It was more his folks, too, were doing this. His dad, Joe, was an elder at our church, First Presbyterian Church in Tacoma. And Ada, his wife, opened up their home to a Bible study. And we were a Presbyterian church, but we had a really good, I mean, a very fine Baptist Bible study teacher. And so when we were in high school, we had a lot of people crowded into their front room out there just past Lincoln where they were living. And for high school kids, that was very important. The Lord really used that time. And I look back on those very, very fine moments where we were sharing together in God's Word.
Thank you, Chuck. Rice Krispies for seeds. That's pretty creative. Somebody else have a story? Yeah. Tell us who you are.
So my name is Scott Bird. I'm a relative of Roy's. My late father was Roy's cousin. And part of a story, but it's part of a, just sort of a statement that I wanted to make, and that is that Roy not only was a dynamic person, but came from probably the greatest person I've ever known, which is Ada Williams. His mother was a living saint to me. Treated me like her own son when I lived in Tacoma for a period of time. And Roy, like his mom, had a very generous, brotherly spirit. Couldn't have been more grounded in his faith. Was a great father, an example to me of what a real father should be. I admired him. He was a very dynamic person, capable, innovative. I think probably underappreciated in the industry, which has gone through so many changes over the years. One of the things I remember most about Roy is his ability to deal with so many varieties of people, including people in my own family, my immediate family, who were some challenging personalities. But despite it all, despite having to deal with people who were demanding, sometimes unreasonable, he was able to be very positive. He was able to be equanimous, that's not the right word. He was balanced. And Roy, you know, I never heard him say anything bad about anybody. He was one of the finest people I know, and I'm glad I could be here, and I want all of you to know that he was just a superhuman being, so thanks.
Thank you, Scott. I think we can do one more.
Thanks, Ray. David Woodward. I was sitting back in the corner here, I think it was a December 15 years ago, and Roy heard me talking with someone, introducing myself, and he goes, what are you doing with international people and cross-cultural stuff? And he goes, could we possibly work together? And he had a vision. People may not realize that he was part Sioux. And you'll see in the narthex a reference to a movie he created, More Than Bows and Arrows. He was very proud of that. And so he had a vision, and he asked if my nonprofit organization could work with him to get a grant to create a series of DVDs to teach Native American children literacy. It was a really interesting concept, something we'd never done. I became really fascinated with the challenges of how to assist Native American communities as a white person. Very difficult to do, to gain trust and so forth. But we were successful in getting a grant. We created a series of these DVDs. Michael, remember that? That's why I came. I wanted to make sure to see you, Mike. And you know, it was really an honor to work with him. He was a man of tremendous integrity. Brilliant guy, when it came to faith, he was just somebody really, really who clung to his values deeply. And we just had a great time, a couple of years working together. When my organization was in deep trouble, he stepped in, and for next to nothing, he created a promotional video for us, one of the very few we ever had, and it was really well done. And my favorite memory of that is he's interviewing this little girl over in West Seattle about our little foreign language program for elementary school kids. He had this great way of interviewing people. And on video, she goes something about the most exciting thing that's ever happened in her life. She's six, you know. And he just had a great way of eliciting wonderful comments from people and a great voice in his narration as well. Anyway, just really an honor to be here and honor him.
Thank you. Okay, Pat, we'll let you go and then we'll sing.
Well, I'm Pat Larson, and my fondest memories of Roy are in connection with the youth department here at the church when he was our elder for the youth department. And the events I remember centered around the holidays when he would either rent or borrow a truck and put sides on the back so we wouldn't fall off, and get some bales of hay for us to sit on. And we'd go around Christmas caroling to all the shut-ins from this church. And another time, they had a boat, a nice, good-sized boat. And at Christmas time, when we had the Christmas ships going through the city, a lot of us would pile onto his boat and follow the Christmas boat fleet as they caroled in the different communities around the lake.
Yeah, the Liberty Bell. Okay, here we go. Last one.
I apologize, but I just couldn't help saying a few words about Roy Williams. The very name Roy Williams. My name is Mel Lyon, and I'm from Silver Creek, Washington. And a few years ago, that is in the late 80s, Roy and I got acquainted. I was going to develop a video for promotional purposes in our church work. So got in touch with Roy. And Roy came to visit me, and then later he invited me up to his home. When I came to his home, he explained how to get there, and it was kind of secluded. And as I got there, I found a large man and a very large dog sitting in the yard with a shotgun across his lap. And a coonskin, I think, on his head, and he looked like the marshal of somebody up in the mountains of Montana. And I hit the brakes. I thought I'm in the wrong place, but no, it was Roy. He helped me develop a wonderful video that was responsible for bringing at least 25 people into Christian work as a livelihood. And I just think so much of my memories of Roy. Thank you.
Thank you. Well, Roy's faith was deep and wide because Jesus is Lord. Let's sing to that, shall we, Brenda? Help us sing.
This is going to be difficult if you don't get here quick. Oh, there. Okay, Roy did love his family, and he did love film. And
And Roy did not always have good ideas. And I'll tell you how I know. Because I worked with Roy in a film where I was supposed to be a young, pregnant wife. Well, trying to make me that young, pregnant wife, we came up with this ingenious idea that we'd take a colander and we'd rip the legs off. And then we'd just strap it to me. So I was going through my little motions and walking up and down these stairs, and Roy just kept saying, "Cut! Brenda, the baby is falling." And so I still bear the scars today from the duct tape that kept the baby in place. Shall we all rise? We are going to do something that Roy loved to do. He was my junior high music teacher. And one of the songs that Roy loved was Deep and Wide. And these wonderful people here are going to make sure you make no mistakes. Ha! This is going to be fun. He taught it to junior hires, so you can imagine where this is going. Let's spread out a little bit. And I'm just going to walk you through the motions. It's real simple. It goes like this. Deep and wide. Oh, you guys are good. Deep and wide. There's a fountain, give it to me, flowing deep and wide. And then we do that one more time because it's so much fun. Deep and wide. Deep and wide. There's a fountain flowing deep and wide. You guys are not very good. All right. So we're going to now sing to it. It's not hard. It goes like this. Deep and wide, deep and wide. There's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Woo! Made it. Deep and wide, deep and wide. There's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Good, Joe. You almost got two of them. Okay, so we're going to move on now, since that was so easy and you guys are doing so well. I'm going to let you in on a little secret. As we continue to sing this song, which we will do ad nauseum, we are going to slowly eliminate some of the words. We will do this one more time with the deep and wide, deep and wide. The second time we're going to go, and wide. And wide. There's a fountain flowing, and wide. And then we do that again. And wide. And wide. There's a fountain flowing, and wide. And then we'll do that with the next word and so on. Let's see how coordinated you really are. And give Roy a good laugh. Here we go. Deep and wide. Deep and wide. There's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Deep and wide. Deep and wide. There's a fountain flowing deep and wide. Here we go with the and wide. And wide, there's a fountain flowing and wide. Good. And wide. And wide, there's a fountain flowing and wide. Let's pick it up a little bit. And and there's a fountain flowing and oh, I heard wide. And there's a fountain flowing and okay, keep going. And and there's a flowing and 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 there's a flowing and this is easy, it's all hmms, faster. And there's a and there's a yay! Roy was my wonderful junior high director 20 years ago. Okay, you guys aren't going to be nice. Okay, so it was 40 years ago, but we did have a lot of fun. And Roy loved his Heavenly Father. He loved God.
And this is a special song to him, and we're going to sing it together. It's called He is Lord. Sing it with me. He is Lord, He is Lord, He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. Once more. He is Lord. He is Lord. He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord. Every knee shall bow, every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Look at the back of our order of service, the bottom paragraph. It says, when Roy passed, he was just starting work on what he believed was his ultimate purpose in life, Comfort Chapel. It's a new way to deliver a worship experience to shut-ins and others who can't make it to a Sunday service. During their last conversation, Mike promised Roy that the work would continue and he would see it through. So please keep the project in your prayers and hold Mike accountable. Comfort Chapel. Well, I was there at Roy's side when it was just him and us and the Lord, and he was soon to be with just the Lord and the great cloud of witnesses. And there was some comfort, there's some music, and there were a few words, and shared a few stories. And memories flooded my mind on the Liberty Bell, the boat, going through the locks, laughing, arguing, making up, understanding, envisioning, doing great things, learning, loving Mike and Peter and Peggy, and even my daughter Heather kind of liked you guys too, so. Lots of connections over the years. So the memories are deep, but the message is clear. For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son so that whoever believes in Him will not perish, but have everlasting life. Amen. Let's watch some more. Thank you. John, come on up.
My name is John, and I was a little apple picker, but I loved meeting with Roy. He was so wonderful, one of the master communicators. I shared this story with him in a hospital. A little four-year-old Linda one day was sitting in the front of the church. The pastor was doing a children's story. And little Linda was sitting in the back, and the pastor said, I'm going to ask you children a very, very difficult question. How many of you know the 23rd Psalms? Wow. For children to know that? In the back of the row, little Linda, four-year-old Linda, raised her hand and waved it like that. He's come up here, Linda. And he looked at her, Linda, you know the 23rd Psalm? She says, uh-huh. He said, would you turn around and face the congregation? About 700 people there, scare you to death. Would you face the congregation and repeat the 23rd Psalms? She says, uh-huh. Turned around, gave him a big smile. The Lord is my shepherd and is all I want. And she went back and sat down. Pastor stood there for a couple minutes in silence, and everybody was shedding tears. Isaiah 54 says, the Lord has given you, Roy, the tongue of the learned, that you should know how to speak a word in season to them that are weary, like myself and Anita, who were weary and were heavy laden once, and you counseled us in the Lord. Over 60 years ago, we first met Peggy at Auburn Academy. Then as time went on, Roy appeared. Wow, what a nice fella. He would be really missed from today. Roy and Peggy included us in their personal lives, their family, and into their circle of friendships. It brought to us a close bonding with two wonderful people. They have truly showed us a lot about God by their example and how to treat people, the rich or the poor. For them to reach down to two ordinary people like Anita and I and lifting us up into their busy lives and their world has been an often trip. This close friendship has been certainly shaped Anita and our lives in the Lord through the years. We are forever grateful to have this long-lasting friendship with them and not forgetting their loyalty to each other, their church, and to their country called United States of America. God bless America. How many say amen to that? I'd like to take little Gabriel here. I give a final tribute after taps. Thank you.
Well, that was beautiful. And we are going to now join John. And this time we're going to sing it because it's such a great song and it means so very much. So if you would sing with me, Amazing Grace.
Prayer. You will live out the prayer. You will be the prayer. The little word benediction comes from two Latin words, bene, meaning good, diction, meaning words, all things words. So a good word. Couple of good words, Roy Williams. Mine were faith, family, and film, and lots of you shared words, stories, memories, smiles, tears, and they go with us. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you with that amazing grace. May the Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you peace, both now and forevermore. Go and be the prayer. And let's let Mike and the family kind of go first, and then we'll have some ice cream sundaes, some conversation, some stories, a few hugs, and go out and be the prayer. God bless you.